This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is video 4 of three-dimensional coordinate systems. In this video, we're going to talk about spheres. So, a sphere in space is the set of all points that are equidistant to some center point. So if we call the center point P naught, so P sub 0, let's call that X naught, Y naught, Z naught, then any point that is a distance of, let's say, A away from that center point is going to be a point on the sphere. So point P, X, Y, Z, is on the sphere if the distance from P naught to P equals A. Okay, so this was in your notes. A point P, X, Y, Z, lies on a sphere of radius A centered at P naught, X naught, Y naught, Z naught, when the distance from P naught to P equals A. We can use the distance formula and square both sides of the distance from P naught to P equaling A. And this will result in the following equation for a sphere. X minus X naught quantity squared plus Y minus Y naught quantity squared plus Z minus Z naught quantity squared equals A squared. So I just squared both sides of my distance formula. So this is what we would call the standard equation of a sphere. And from that, we know the center is at X naught, Y naught, Z naught. Notice they'll have opposite signs of what you see in the parentheses. And radius A. So you'll take the square root of whatever number is on the right side of your equation. Okay, example 6 from the notes. Find the center and radius of the sphere 3x squared plus 3y squared plus 3z squared plus 2y minus 2z equals 9. So we want to get this into standard form so that we can figure out the center and radius. So to get it into standard form, we want it to be x minus a number quantity squared plus y minus a number squared plus z minus a number squared equals a squared. So in order to do this, we will have to complete the square. So it may have been a while for some of you since you have had to complete the square. So let's review that really quickly. Completing the square, our first step is to divide by the coefficient in front of the squared terms. So when we're figuring out how to complete the square, we don't want a non-1 number in front of the squared terms. So in our example, we would divide by 3. Now just a note on step 1. When you're looking at a sphere, the x squared, y squared, and z squared would all have the same number in front of them. Otherwise, it would not be a sphere. It would be some kind of ellipse, maybe. Okay, step 2, once you have it in the form x squared plus bx equals d, so you've divided by the coefficient of the squared term, you add b over 2 quantity squared to both sides. Step 3 is the left-hand side will factor as x plus b over 2 quantity squared, and you're doing this for each variable, so you might have y plus b over 2 quantity squared or z plus b over 2 quantity squared for your other variables. So now let's try it with our example. So we need to divide by 3, so we divide everything. So we started with 3x squared plus 3y squared plus 3z squared plus 2y minus 2z equals 9. So we divide everything by 3, and we get x squared plus y squared plus z squared plus 2/3 y minus 2/3 z equals 3. Now what we want to do is get all of our x terms together, get all of our y terms together, and get all of our z terms together, because we'll be completing the square on each variable separately. So x squared is already a completed square because it doesn't have any plus bx term. So let's move on to the y. We have y squared plus 2/3 y. So our b is 2/3, so we do b over 2 squared, which would give us 1/3 squared, which is 1/9. So I'm going to add 1/9 to my y terms. But to balance my equation, I have to add 1/9 to the right-hand side of the equation. So I add 1/9 over there to the 3. Now I focus on the z terms. So my b is negative 2/3. So b over 2 squared is negative 1/3 squared. So it's a 1/9 again. So I add 1/9 to the z terms. I add it to the other side of the equation to balance the equation. And now I factor. So I get x squared plus y plus 1/3 quantity squared plus z minus 1/3 quantity squared equals 29/9. So you can check my math, make sure that that I factored correctly and added my 3 plus 1/9 plus 1/9 correctly. So now we pull out the center and radius from that. The center is going to be 0, negative 1/3, positive 1/3. So notice it's the opposite sign of what you see in the parentheses, and that's directly from our formula. The radius is the square root of the number on the right-hand side. So square root of 29 over 3, because the square root of 9 gave us the 3 in the denominator. So that's how you find the center and radius of a sphere. Get it into standard form by completing the square, and then just pull out the center and radius from that formula. Okay, now the last thing we want to do is kind of put everything together that we've learned in the videos for this section. So we want to describe the given set with a pair of equations. The circle in which the plane through the point 381 perpendicular to the y-axis meets the sphere of radius 10 centered at the origin. So we know that we're going to have a circle as our final figure. And the circle's defined by a plane perpendicular to the y-axis through the point 381. So let's think about the formula for that. We know if it's perpendicular to the y-axis, it's going to be y equals a number. So in this point, the y value is 8 because it's the point 381. So we get the equation y equals 8. That's the plane. And now the other figure that we have is the sphere of radius 10 centered at 0, 0, 0, so centered at the origin. So we have x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 100, because we know that the radius squared is on the right-hand side of the equation. So we want to find where these two intersect. So we substitute y equals 8 into the equation for our sphere, x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 100. So we get x squared plus 64 plus z squared equals 100. Subtract that 64 from both sides, and we get x squared plus z squared equals 36. So we know we have a circle of radius 6 parallel to the xz plane, and then we also have the restriction y equals 8. So our pair of equations is x squared plus y squared excuse me, x squared plus z squared equals 36, and y equals 8. So this is a circle of radius 6, parallel to the xz plane, and centered at 0, 8, 0. Now let's just sketch this to get an idea of what it would look like. I have my x, y, and z axes. My sphere centered at the origin with radius 10, I'm going to sketch that first. And I know that the plane is going to go through the point y equals 8. So I'm going to mark y equals 8 on my y-axis. And I already know that the plane's going to slice a circle out of the sphere. So I have this circle centered at 0, 8, 0 with a radius of 6, just kind of sliced out of this sphere. So the plane will cut through the sphere and create a circle. So that's an example of putting together the concepts that you've learned about planes and spheres.